Mark your calendar for Sunday evening, November 13th, 7 o'clock. We will gather for our annual charge conference. Our district superintendent, Alan Brooks, will be here, and we'll be having worship and be about the church's business as we do every year. It's that time of year again where the youth group is selling calendars and notepads. They're out in the Narthex areas. They make good gifts. As we think about another new year, it's hard to believe, but they would appreciate your support of that fundraiser. We are collecting pillowcases for a couple more weeks. Those will be used to give to the homeless people in Pittsburgh to carry some of their belongings. So they don't have to be new, just in good shape. November 13th is a deadline. This afternoon will be trunk or treat at Leisure Run from 2 to 4. You can participate either by taking your children or by decorating your car and passing out some goodies. The bazaar is coming up next Saturday already from 9 to 2. I'm sure there's some announcements about all that. There'll be a bake sale, I know. Joe, do you want to? You need some salads for the lunch. So if you'd like to donate a salad and help Joe from making a bunch of phone calls this week, I should say, check with her and she can help you out. Any other announcements about the bazaar?
We have a granny's attic and it's in the parlor this year. So if you have any items, put them in the parlor.
There's some collecting already, I see. Yes.
In addition to the salad luncheon, we are also featured in Sandy Barrett's homemade sweet rolls and peanut butter rolls and some very good breads from other bakers in here earlier in the day.
So that'll be right at 9 o'clock.
Yes.
Yes. All right, so we can come and eat breakfast and stay for lunch.
Yes.
And lots of good crafts to purchase, bake sale items, and great exotic. Just a reminder, no clothes, no shoes, no books, and no electronics. For the granny's attic. And the sooner you get those things here this week, the easier it'll be for those who are putting that together. On Tuesday evening at 7 o'clock at the library, there'll be an open house and a presentation on the Middle East War Military Veterans Quilt. I've seen the quilt, and we'll talk about that in a little bit. I encourage you to attend that open house. Also next Saturday is the Black Kettle Chili Cook, sponsored by New Salem folks down at Downtown Park. Starting at 11:30 until it's gone. So keep that in mind as well. And the St. Nicholas Altary Rosary Society will have a pork and sauerkraut or ham and bean dinner next Sunday afternoon. And I think we covered it on that page. So the calendar. Tomorrow night is Bible study at First Church, Wednesday night at Oak Ridge. Both the men and women's breakfast will be held this week on Thursday morning, the men at 7, the women at 8. A ministry team meeting coming up next week, November 15th, at Fairmount City. The prayer vigil has been moved up a week because of the Thanksgiving holiday, so that'll be on November 17th at 7 o'clock here at First Church. Choir and handbell practices on Wednesday. This week will be our council meeting and finance meeting. The finance committee will meet at 6:15, council at 7. Just a reminder that if you're a member of the church, you're also a member of church council and have a vote, but everyone has a voice, so I encourage you to attend. Youth will be coming up next week, United Methodist Women on November 10th. One more Bible study will be adding to our schedule during Advent. If you're interested in a daytime Bible study and maybe a short-term Bible study, we'll be beginning the Monday after Thanksgiving, November 28th, for four consecutive Mondays from 10 to 11, at South Bethlehem House. And while it is for their residents as well, I would encourage any of you to attend there as well to get ready for Advent once again. Those are the announcements from the bulletin. Does anybody have any others?
Yes.
Oh. I was a little curious when I saw you all sitting down there.
Yeah. The Greek word for pastor is poimen. It means herdsman, a shepherd, one who cares for, feeds, guides, and protects the sheep. Some in the position of pastor have the gift of leadership, some the gift of evangelism, some the gift of administration, and some the gift of teaching, preaching. and there are those who believe that one person cannot have all these gifts. But I think we as a congregation agree that that is not the case. Today we must
some jewelry, which is always a good thing. Thank you very much. Very nice. Add those to my collection. Thank you very much. And thank you. Thank all of you. You make my job much easier, and I appreciate all of you. And your willingness just to follow and support and encourage me and my ministry as well as the ministry. Thank you again very much. Are there any other announcements? All right, then let's take a couple minutes to pass the peace of Christ.
Hello.
Our praise hymn is on page 2223 in the Faith We Sing. Just one addition to the announcements, there'll be a very quick trustees meeting immediately following church today. So if you're on the trustees, if we could stay for a few minutes, that would be great. All right, so let's turn to our praise hymn.
Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
God who came to seek and save the lost.
Let us worship the God who came to seek and save each of us.
Let us welcome God into our homes and our hearts.
Let us give ourselves in this worship time that we may know God.
Let us joyfully and with gratitude worship God. And our worship begins with hymn number 400.
Thank you.
all that you give to us and are to us. We give you thanks, Lord. And we pray that the ministry of this church may thrive with the use of these offerings. We ask that you would bless them and multiply them and bless each giver. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Our hymn is on page 391.
Thank you.
kids would like to come up front now. Good morning.
Good morning.
We have some scary looking characters around here this morning. How come you're all dressed up? Tomorrow's Halloween, that's right. Do you have a pumpkin? Did you cut a face or some kind of a figure into your pumpkin? And what did you put in the middle of your pumpkin? A candle. And why do you do that? So people can see the face that you put in, right? You can see it, right? Any other reason? Well, I brought a pumpkin with me this morning. The pumpkin in. The light came on, didn't it? Do we have a light inside of us? What's the light inside of us? Right, Jesus. And Jesus tells us in the Bible, Jesus tells us in the Bible that we should not cover up our light. That we should let our light shine. So what are some ways that we can let our light shine? Praying, right?
Believing in God.
Believing in God, good. How about how we treat other people? You should be nice to them, right? Absolutely. And then people will see that light of Christ shining in us, and what will they want to do? They want to follow us, right? And where are we going to lead them to? Right? We can help them to learn how to believe in God and what Jesus teaches us by the way that we act. Okay? So when you light your pumpkin tomorrow night, you also remember that you're lighting the light of Christ within you. All right? Let's pray this morning. God, we thank you for the light of Christ that's in each of us. And we thank you, God, that we're able to shine that light in the darkness of this world in all that we say and all that we do, regardless of our age. And so we pray, Lord, that you would help us to let our light shine for you. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Would you like a Halloween treat?
Woo!
Yes.
As we move into our time of joys and concerns, Amy Smith has something to share with us about an idea that you came up with.
Together pumpkin praises. There's a bulletin board in the back this pumpkin with a pen and slips of paper will be back there. You can write your praise, drop it in the pumpkin. We will share a few during each service, and as well, we will post them on the bulletin board after the service so we can be sharing our praises with everyone. Thank you.
Okay, some of the praises we have for today is the beautiful weather, that winter is coming eventually, that God is always with us and that He always cares for us, and He's good to us all the time. That's what we have for today.
Okay, thank you very much. So that's the joys that you have to share. What do you have to share this morning?
God's love and grace.
God's love and grace, yes.
Joy to be with you here this morning. I don't get over here very often, but I love the choir number. Thank you. I thought that was wonderful.
Yeah. Okay. Majesty of creation. Yes, well, I can have more of the
We serve the only living God.
Right. Time of family and friends was also mentioned.
God is good all the time.
All the time. Any other joys?
Thankful for the consolation
that
you did bring
to us. Oh, thank goodness for that. Answer prayers.